everyone, so I'm going to be teaching you how to run today. Now, so many of you have asked me on how to run, the correct posture of running. If you have bought my book Run, then this is exactly what I'm going to teach you today. So once you follow this tutorial of how to run, I would like for you to buy the book, because everything that you want to know about running and more is going to be in that book. Today I want to teach the basics, and I really want you to watch my form, because that is the most important thing when it comes to running. I feel like a lot of people go off in their form, their arms are running everywhere, their legs are stomping, and they're not getting faster for a reason. So we are going to begin by learning how to stand correctly first. As a runner, the first important thing to know is that if you're going to be running straight, your toes have to point forward at all times. You're going to be running straight, you're going to run forward. So if your toes are going to point at that angle, you're not going to be able to run faster ahead. So very important that you focus on your toes being straight at all times. After that, you want to pull your knees out to the outer side so that your knee is directly on top of the ankle. From there, I want you to focus as if you're going to sit on a little chair behind you. Okay? This is called sink and relax. This is what my coach Gavin taught me. He said sink into your hip and relax into the ground when you're running. So very important. First important note of running is learning how to stand correctly. The minute your feet are hip width apart, knees are directly aligned with your ankle, and knees are then aligned with your hip, you're sitting square from here, and this is all I want you to feel right now. If you want to stand barefoot, you are most welcome to stand barefoot. Feel the ground below you. If not, I just want you to feel this motion for a couple of seconds. Stay here and start aligning your legs. Hip to knee are your legs, knee to your ankle are your lower limbs. So I want you to just focus on learning how to stand correctly first. So once you have learned how to stand correctly, which is the posture that I'm standing in right now, the next step is learning how to walk correctly. If you can walk correctly through your hips, remember, we're initiating the movement from the hip. We're telling people to not run from their knees. We're actually telling them how to initiate movement from their hip. So once you have learned how to stand correctly, I want you to imagine that you are a basketball player, okay? If you watch American basketball players, they're always bouncing. You never see them walking. You always see them bouncing from their hip. They always have this soft bounce. So if you watch my knees are not initiating the movement. It is my hip that moves. It is the knee that is following that movement. So I want you to pay very careful attention to how my body language is when I'm walking. Also, I believe that body language has a lot to do with confidence. Your posture speaks a lot about your confidence. So very important of how you walk, how you put yourself out there when you're going to be a runner. Okay? So standing with that toes pointing straight, knees soft, hips sinking into the ground, and walk. Okay, that was step two. Now, we are going to move into step three of learning how to run correctly from the hip. So step three is now learning how to jog from your hip. We're not going to be teaching sprinting, because you don't need to be a sprinter. You all are mostly marathon and distance runners. So learning how to jog correctly is very important over learning how to run fast. Okay? So we learned how to sink into our hip. We learned how to walk. Now from here, it may sound very, very ridiculous. And my coach always said, when you'll be different, people will laugh at you. So I want you to be different. I want you to do what is actually correct and not what you're watching other people doing, which is very wrong. Okay? And I say this is wrong because I have been in the field of running for a long time, and I know exactly how posture works, and I know how exactly posture can change your injuries and your recovery. Okay? So watch this really carefully. Imagine that you're sitting on a chair. Now, I don't want you to run like this, but I still want you to imagine that you're running soft, sitting on that high stool or that high chair behind you, and I want you to feel like you're going to be sitting and running, but you're not really sitting like sit. Okay, so watch very carefully. I'm going to start walking. you watch this motion very, very carefully, I want you to notice that my heel lands first and my midfoot lands second. That is very common. Not everyone has the skill of learning how to run from midfoot to front foot. It's a very difficult thing to accomplish as a distance runner, and you mostly only see Africans running like that. Not saying that it's a bad thing to run from heel to midfoot, but it's okay to run that way. Work on ankle mobility like I keep stressing on. I'm gonna show you one more run, and I want you to watch really carefully of how my hip initiates the movement and not my knees. A lot of people tend to run like, this is wrong. If you're running with your foot kicking back, this is the wrong posture that you're using. Okay, I want you to actually utilize your hip. Hip, I always say, is the biggest weight-bearing joint in our body, so utilize it well. Okay, I'm gonna run again for you. Okay, so that was the third part of our running. Please note that standing like this and running the way I just taught you is a matter of practice. This is not going to come overnight. This is something that you need to do daily, also in front of the mirror. Okay, standing like this. From here, we are going to move into step number 4, which is very essential, which is what will also get your posture more into place when you're actually running on the road. So we move on to step number 4. Step number 4 is your arms. Now, why do we not pay so much attention to our arms when we're running? Because we typically think that running is a motion of the legs. Wrong. That's a myth. And if anybody is telling you you don't need your arms really to run, they're fooling you, because it is your arms that actually drive you to run faster and better. Remember, equal and opposite reactions. So if your arms are not running smooth, how are your legs going to run smoother? Here is a very simple exercise, and a lot of you have seen me doing it on my Instagram, and I want you to do it in front of the mirror every single day. So you put your foot, again the way I taught you, toes pointing straight, knees soft, okay? Keeping the hips square, constantly standing in this position. Now, get your hands at your navel level, okay? Just about your navel level. I've seen so many runners, not just in India, but across the world, who run like this. Can you imagine how much pressure you put onto your shoulder when you're running like this? Your shoulders are caving in, your lungs are collapsing, and you're not allowing yourself to breathe. So all I want you to focus on is having this 90 degree angle. If your hands come a little bit this way, it's totally fine, but you don't want to completely be running here. This is what is not getting you faster. You're allowing the wind to cut through sideways, which is wasting a lot of seconds. You want to learn how to cut through the wind straight. Angles are really important when you're running, which is why we're so focused on our posture. Okay, I want you to watch this, and I want you to imitate this, but also be aware of when you're doing it, when you watch yourself in the mirror, that your arms are running at your chest level, hands at your chest level, and your elbows are running through your hip. They're not running here. Okay, so very important, you get pocket to mouth, pocket to mouth. This is a very important thing that Savio D'Souza taught us. We'll never forget how he focused so much on runners' arms. He always said, drive your arms, pump your arms, because it's your arms that will drive you to run faster. Not to forget that my legs are also still very stationary of where we started off from step number 1. So this is very relaxing. Also, anybody who has shoulder pain, shoulder tightness, running correctly with your arms will actually start reducing that pain. So focus on this, breathe, shut your eyes, feel the movement, and find a rhythm, because at the end of the day, running is about finding rhythm. It's not about how fast or slow you run. If you find good rhythm, you're going to run better. So that was a video on learning how to run. If you liked it, share it with the people who you think might benefit from it. Subscribe to my channel on YouTube. Follow me on Instagram for more of these fun workouts and tips that you're gonna get better as a runner. And I hope this has been very, very helpful. And thank you for watching, and keep running, keep miling, and keep smiling.